All right, welcome back to the second hour of this Tuesday edition, the Focal Point. AFR Talk, Brian Fisher is my name. Program is Focal Point. You are on board the USS Focal Point. It is our patrol boat in which we patrol the choppy waters of America's public life, looking relentlessly for the coordinates where truth intersects with politics, where truth, the truth of God's word, intersects with our shared common public life. Together, our commander is on the bridge. The scriptures serve as our nautical charts. Remember, United States government is no longer printing nautical charts. Doesn't matter to the USS Focal Point because we are not dependent for our nautical charts on the United States government. Our nautical charts come right from the Word of God. We still steer and navigate by those nautical charts, and I serve as your loyal, humble, and cheerful first mate. Talking about two topics in the first hour, and we'll take more phone calls on this as the program unfolds. We're going to shift a little bit to Obamacare and other topics here, so you're welcome to call in on that subject as well. Talked in the first hour about conservative parents who wind up with left-wing children. How does that happen and what can be done about that? And question two had to do with the morale in the military because of what I believe and a lot of other retired military generals believe is a systematic purge by President Obama of senior military officers. These are generals and other flag officers that are being purged from the military. And according to Lieutenant General Jerry Boykin, a lot of this has to do with the fact that they simply are not politically correct. And so President Obama is getting rid of them. He is cleaning the military out of these values-driven senior officers. And what Boykin says is another problem. Not only are we losing the most experienced and the most mature and the wisest leadership that we have in the military, but young guys coming into the military, they look at what's happening and says, look, I don't see any future for me here. My values, the values that I had when I came into the military, would have given me a bright future here. But the values that I now see the military adopting are so antithetical to my values. And if you have to believe in those values to advance in this outfit, then I've got no chance. I've got no future here, so they are not re-upping. So this is fine in my mind with President Obama. He wants America to be weak. He wants America's military to be weak because he doesn't like this country. So he's fine with making this country vulnerable on all fronts. You got military leaders now saying, look, we can't even fight a one-front war, let alone a two-front war. We're not even in a position to fight a one-front war. So even our own leadership admitting that this president has made this military weaker virtually by the day. So take calls on those topics, 888-589-8840. Let's go to Patricia in Little Rock, Arkansas, if we can bring Patricia in. Patricia, welcome to Focal Point with Brian Fisher. What's on your mind?
Hi, thank you.
Yes, thanks for calling.
I've been listening to the radio a lot. I'm a truck driver, so I get to listen quite a bit when I can get the different stations. And in connecting some of the dots, I'm just really concerned that we have a Hitler in a black skin, that with the executive orders that I've read that he's put forth as far as being able to take control of everything, the government taking control of everything when he says so, the purging of the military, the Muslim Brotherhood people that are in upper offices all over up there in D.C., I'm just really concerned that he's just going to, right before the election, he's going to declare martial law, and one of the executive orders says nobody can do anything about it for 6 months, so therefore, here comes third-term President, Obama, and mm-hmm. I'm going, oh my gosh, I hope this guy really isn't thinking of doing this, but it sure adds up.
Well, and and it may be interesting that, I want to be careful how I put this because I'm not advocating anything. Don't misunderstand me here. But kind of the last line of defense that we would have from a complete totalitarian takeover by somebody like President Obama is our military. Because Congress is not standing up to this president. House of Representatives is not standing up to this president. The Supreme Court is giving this guy everything he wants. They're not standing up to this president. So who is going to stop this guy? I mean, there is nobody right now that is willing to stop this guy. Now, Congress could stop him through articles of impeachment. And probably most of us in this listening audience believe that he has done things that are impeachable offenses. You've got Steve Stockman from Texas talking about the fact, I think it was him, maybe it was another congressman, that if articles of impeachment were filed right now, it could probably get a majority in the House of Representatives to actually impeach the president. Now, he wouldn't get convicted because the Senate would conduct the trial. So, but the point is, you don't see the will to pursue impeachment, number one. And number two, it wouldn't be successful if it was pursued because the Democrats would band together to keep from convicting him. So then you start asking yourself the question, well, how in the world do you stop a totalitarian president who is not bound by the law? He's not restrained by the Constitution. He's not impeachable. He's issuing one executive order after another. You know, and one of the latest is this executive order about what he's going to do for global warming. And he's given himself and his administration all sorts of powers. He's already through the EPA. They virtually shut down the entire coal industry. The standards are so stringent that a lot of coal plants are being shut down, and it will be impossible for a new coal-fired plant to open up because the standards are ridiculous. I mean, they're completely unnecessary, and they require technology that does not yet exist. I mean, the technology to do the carbon sequestration that the EPA is demanding that these coal companies do doesn't even exist. They can't do it even if they wanted to. They're already, you got these petroleum companies, they're being fined by the EPA for not producing cellulosic fuel. It's a biofuel. Well, it doesn't even exist. They have a mandate to produce X number of gallons of this cellulosic biofuel by this year, by over the last couple of years is when the mandate went into effect. It doesn't even exist. Nobody's even invented that, but they still are getting fined by the EPA for not producing a fuel that does not even exist. I mean, that's how far into la-la land we are with these policies. And, you know, and President Obama's out there issuing another executive order about he's going to take over all environmental policy on his own. You know, and I'm looking at a piece here from the Daily Mail in the UK. Global warming pause may last for 20 more years. And this is in a peer-reviewed journal called Climate Dynamics by Professor Judith Curry of the Georgia Institute of Technology and a Dr. Marcia Wyatt. And they've produced this article, published it in a peer-reviewed journal, that not only has there been no global warming for the last 17 years, there probably isn't going to be any global warming for another 20 years. If we see any global warming again in this century, it won't be until 2033. And yet President Obama, all of his executive orders, all of the EPA work, all of it is predicated on the fact, number one, there is global warming, and number two, man is causing it. Neither of those is true. They're both myths. They're fantasies. And yet President Obama is completely hamstringing the American industry, hamstringing our energy industry, wasting millions and billions of dollars on these alternate energy projects for a problem that does not exist. Don't forget, no global warming since 1995. That means no child in the face of the planet has ever witnessed global warming. Focal Point AFR Talk, back in 2 minutes.